If you're looking for the cheapest and most reliable Madden 22 coins on the market, check out my sponsor, MMOEXPR.com. Links are in the description, and use code JEDI at checkout for 5% off. All right, hey there, guys. Aiden DaCosta here, aka JEDI Ronin. Coming at you guys with another video. And in this video, guys, I'm going to be going over all of the content for Team of the Week and then the heavyweights cards that are coming out tomorrow. Now, if I do cough a few times in this video, I did mention this in my last video, but I will be brief again. I am recovering from a cold. That's why my voice still sounds pretty scratchy and I'm still having a bad cough. So if I do cough a few times in the video, I do apologize, guys. I cannot control that. But for the LTD for the week, we got Chase Edmonds. So powered up, 94 speed, 95 acceleration, 91 agility, 91 carrying, 86 catching, 93 change of direction, 64 trucking, and an 89 break tackling. Now this card is good and bad for multiple reasons. Obviously it's good. It's not a power back. So it can get some good route running abilities. Like it can get backfield mismatch and running back apprentice. But the bad thing is it's not a receiving back, so it can't get backfield master for one AP. But still, having an elusive back, like a do everything back like an elusive back, is still pretty great. So yeah, I'm okay with this Chase Edmonds. He actually does look pretty good though. He looks like he could be the best running back in the game. Next we have Roddy White. Now this one had a little bit of controversy come out today with it. So powered up, 93 speed, 95 jumping, 93 catching and catching traffic, 90 spec catch, 91, 93, and 91 for the route running. This one came a bit of a controversy today because apparently people, when they were doing the sets for the Roddy White, they were getting the power up and it was listed at 93 overall, and then they were selling it on the market. Obviously that wasn't supposed to happen. The Roddy Whites were not supposed to be 93 power up. The power up was not supposed to be 93. If I remember correctly, the power up is supposed to be an 81 because it's supposed to be 12, I believe is what I heard. If I remember correctly, it's supposed to be 12 overall points below the actual like cards overall, because they obviously want you to buy the power up for the card to get the better stats. So yeah, obviously EA is gonna have to do something about this, because those people that did the sets and then got the 93 powered up Roddy White, and then probably either bought the Roddy White for 90 the power up 93 overall, definitely lost out on some coins too, because obviously it wasn't labeled as a 90. It wasn't supposed to be that way. So who knows? But yeah, this card is still pretty good. Obviously he's a physical wide receiver, so he does get matchup nightmare and red zone threat for one AP for both. Speaking of those abilities, I do think that those are some of the best abilities in the game right now. But yeah, I do like this Roddy White card. Next we have Jay Ratliff, DT power rusher. So powered up, 72 speed, 93 excel and strength, 92 tackling, 91 play rack, 93 block shed, 94 power, and 91 finesse move. Honestly, this card is actually pretty solid for a DT. The speed may not be there fully, which I can understand if it draws you away from it, but honestly this is one of those cards where you have to play it at the D tackle position, because off D tackles realistically don't have the greatest of speeds, and honestly like a 72 speed D tackle is probably where you want to be being right now, because a lot of good D tackles like Michael Pierce, who are one of the better D tackles in the game, have like a 70, like a set, or DeForest Buckner if I'm not mistaken has like a 71 speed. So yeah, this is about where you want to be for the D tackle spot. The only thing other that I have a complaint on this card is the fact that this guy was a cowboy for the majority of his career, and yet they put him in a Bears uniform, which is weird, but I don't know. I don't control that stuff. And then the player of the week for this week was actually Cooper Kupp. 91 speed, 81 jumping, 94 catching, 88 catch in traffic, 90 spec catch, my bad. And then 93, 92, 91 route running. And this card honestly is pretty mid. Like, it is still solid, and the route runner archetype definitely does help him out a lot because he can get route tech for 2 AP. But it's just really sad that he's only at 91 speed. I kind of felt like he would be like a 92, 93 powered up, which is unfortunate. So unless you're rocking a Rams theme team, this Cooper Kupp really is not going to be making anybody's rosters, which is sad because Cooper Kupp this year has been phenomenal. And I do think Cooper Kupp will make a team of the year, will make a team of the year selection. I might, around that time, towards the end of the season, I might lay out my team of the year predictions, for me. So That being said, that's Cooper Kupp. And then we move on to the ones that were revealed today. So this one is Kyle Pitts, 90 overall powered up, 91 speed, 71 strength, 88 catching, 87 catch in traffic, 89 spec, and then 86 and 84 for the route running, and then a 68 run block. Now, this Kyle Pitts and the next card I'm going to showcase to you guys are the free end cats for the week. So this one is, you can't, this one is something, this one is a card you can pick up. Here's the note about this Kyle Pitts, though. The rookie premier item does not go into his power up. It is a completely different thing. Pardon me. It is completely different. The rookie premieres do not go into the power ups, which is stupid. I think the rookie premieres should definitely go into the power ups, but hey, what do I know, right? I'm just the person who makes videos. Pardon me. Then we move on to Devondre Campbell. Now this card is okay, honestly. I know people, a lot of people are making fun of this card. You're like, oh, it's a linebacker, but it, you know, whatever. I'll get to it. So, Devondre Campbell, 87 speed, 90 acceleration, 78 strength, 91 tackling, 88 play rec, 82 block shed, my bad, 86 hit power, and a 74 zone coverage. Now the 74 zone coverage isn't that bad if you user him, and honestly, I think personally. Again, I don't like saying this because I really do think you should not have to use this ability. But just throw Lurker on him and he will be a usable linebacker, okay? I like it's just crazy how people just completely don't even like think about the fact that all you need is just Lurker. Spend the one or two AP and put it on. You can do it. You can make a spot on your team for him. Like, you can do it. It's not hard. But you know, Devondre Campbell is pretty solid. Overall, he'd probably be a better user. Next, we have Sam Hubbard. 79 speed, 84 excel, 76 strength, 87 tackling, 86 play rec, 81 block shed, 73 power move, and 85 finesse move. Nothing special, to be completely honest. Then we have Ernest Johnson. Now, this card's actually a solid budget beast. 90 speed, 92 acceleration, 85 agility, 74 carrying, which is pretty low. But, you know, it's a solid budget option if you guys just want to pick up a card. You guys just need a running back, a fast running back for yourself. This is actually pretty solid, so I would definitely look to pick him up if you're running a budget team. Then we have Aziz, not going to fucking try to pronounce his last name. 89 speed, 92 acceleration, and then nothing really spectacular after that. So this card's mid at best. Now this card was this is for the heavyweights. This card was re also revealed this morning, and it is Al Woods. Now 79 speed, 89 acceleration, 92 strength, 92 tackling, 88 play rec, 93 block shed, 89 power movement, and 61 finesse move. And to be completely honest, I'm okay with this upgrade. You know, as you guys know on the channel, I rock a Hawks theme team. I am completely okay with this upgrade. I know it's not an ideal one. I obviously, like, much like a lot of Hawks fans, I would like to have a cornerback. You know, like we get like someone like Richard Sherman, or maybe we get a Quandre Diggs upgrade, hopefully this week with Most Feared. But I do think that Al Woods, I think, is a fine upgrade. First of all, he's a defensive tackle, which is something that we do need because our second best DT is a gold card, which is Puna Ford. Second, you know, it's a run stopper, so you get inside stuff for 1 AP. So I'm completely fine with this Puna Ford. I really do think he is actually pretty good. Next, we move on to the ones that were revealed tonight. So the first one is Alex Singleton. This one I gotta call shenanigans on, but 89 speed, 91 acceleration, 82 strength, 91 tackling, 84 play rec, 90 block shed and hit power, and 81 zone coverage. Now, I'm not calling shenanigans on this card because it's bad by any means. I actually do think this is a very solid middle linebacker. But the problem with this card is the fact that this is a heavyweights promo, and the last time I checked, the heavyweights are supposed to be are strictly for the offensive and defensive lineman promo. This is the promo for the big guys that do the work in the trenches. Why are we getting a middle linebacker in that spot? It doesn't make sense to me. I just find that really weird. But you know, again, you know, you throw Lurker on him, he's fine. And if I remember correctly, he has like three teams he played for. I think he has like the Saints and the Eagles, and I think that's actually, I think he has two. Let me just quickly check Alex Singleton. Alex Singleton. Let's look at it. Where is his pro football reference stuff? Pro football reference. Here it is. Okay, no. So it's somebody else I'm thinking of. So yeah, he just has Philadelphia. Kem. So that is, again, whatever. Then we have Malik Collins, 81 speed, 89 acceleration and strength and tackling, 90 play rec, 89 block shed, 64 power move, and a 92 finesse move. Now, people are upset because this is a Raider, and I get it. Raiders theme teams should not be getting anything of significance. However, I would not classify this as of significance. First of all, it's a defensive tackle, one of the lower valued positions in the game. It's not like it's a wide receiver or a cornerback or even a quarterback for that matter. Secondly, it's the worst archetype of lineman in the game as speed rusher. They really the line speed rushers for their abilities, they really don't get anything good other than maybe edge threat for 2 AP. Other than that, the run stopping abilities, it actually costs 3 AP for them to get inside stuff. So, yeah. So Malik Collins, I'm okay with the Raiders getting this card. And to be like, again, it's just a whatever D tackle. Big fucking deal. Like, who cares? Next, we have Rob Havenstein. 90 strength, 91 aware, 92 awareness, 91 pass block, 98, 89 pass block power, 92 pass block finesse, and then 93, 91, and 93 for the run blocking stats. Now, this card is actually solid. He's a good right tackle. I would have picked this card up if I didn't already have Taylor Moton as an end cat. And then lastly, we have Natane. I'm not going to try and pronounce his last name. Broncos get alignment tomorrow. So 92 speed, 87 excel, 87 awareness, 90, 92, 92, and then 89 for the pass block stats, and then 90, 92, and 89 for the run block stats. Again, another good offensive lineman. Realistically speaking, offensive linemen are these offensive linemen are pretty good in this game. I actually have no problem with this promo, other than maybe the Alex Singleton, because again, it's just oops. Because again, like I just why are we getting a middle linebacker? Why are we getting a middle linebacker in a heavyweight promo? That just to me it doesn't make sense, but whatever. That is gonna be the end of the video, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy. Hit the like button if you guys did. Subscribe if you guys are new. Again, I do apologize for my raspy voice and coughing, but it is what it is. But I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm out. Peace.